I want you to know and I re-emphasize that this ministerial work, it is not possible for an individual to accomplish it. If anyone says he can do it alone, he that wants to do it alone, without the unity and cooperation of his colleagues in this work, in this ministry, he cannot succeed.
So Jesus God does it.
Jesus even himself did not do it alone.
So, he
cooperated with his disciples.
So back now,
the same thing, my own expectation in the midst of servants of God is this. We will not come in vain in Jesus' name. The first prayer point we are going to offer now, while I was coming out from my house, your own personal life, I place it in the hand of God. And God told me, in this prayer point you are going to give to them, miracle is going to start right from that prayer. From which particular person that miracle will start, I don't know. One thing I know is God will perform wonders today. And what is that prayer point? My own land that is barren, take control with miracle. That is the authority of God. My land that is barren, Lord, you have to take control with miracle tonight. Everything that has prevented the land of my life to bear fruits and bring fruits of joy, of blessings, let them dry up. Oh, the land of my life, in the name of Jesus, receive the work of miracle. Whosoever that came forth through a woman tonight and can open wide his mouth or her mouth, and your own shout is louder than the person by your side, then God is going to start this wonder from you first.
In
the name of Jesus,
and
pray. It is not ordinary prayer you have to offer. Your prayer is not enough. Add more. Pray seriously. Turn the barrenness of my land into fruitfulness. The one that is flowing with milk and honey. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Hear the word of God, all these souls that are listening here. God do not have any other day except this moment in your life. If Jesus bypasses you tonight, and you are unfortunate for him to bypass you this night, without him having mercy on you, I don't know which day again you will receive such a mercy. Because what my God told me is this. The key of your own mercy is in his hand this night. For whosoever will offer this prayer, that he is going to use the key to open the door of mercy for you. And when I offer this prayer, you must not allow the prayer to go by without saying a loud amen.
Amen.
Amen is the answer to every prayer. The key God wants to use for your life tonight, this key, the angels should not take back this key back to heaven. I pray for just 7 people here in the name of Jesus. I remove all shoes of hardship on your feet tonight in Jesus' name. Hear the word of God. All those who have claimed the glory of your life away, the enemy that have made things to be hard for you, so much that you are struggling and struggling, yet you have not making it. Should you take this struggle into next year? Those who have claimed the glory of your life away, the enemies that have brought hardship into your life, so much that to have 3 square means to have money and to have good life is so difficult for your life. Give me your ears also that are here. And open your eyes clearly. God says, one thing is going to use to claim everything from your life. When you call the name of Jesus 3 times, what is going to be next is everything, everybody that makes this to be difficult for your life. And they have turned your life into a common man. And they want to make you a non-entity in the society. When you call the name of Jesus 3 times, you now tell God, Lord, come and use the thunder of God to turn them to nothing. The thunder will not strike in vain. When the thunder strikes, it will bring lightning. Make a loud noise in this prayer. You that you know I am a prophet, I'm talking to you. And God says, if the problem of the person by your both sides are solved tonight, the person by your side who cannot pray will claim your own problem that have been solved. The thunder of God. The thunder of God. May turn them to nothing. Call the name of Jesus 3 times and pray. Call the thunder of God to destroy, make to nothing all people that make things so hard for your life. The thunder of God to destroy them. Pray. Pray louder. Pray, pray. Don't be tired. This is your moment.
This is your opportunity. Call the thunder of God to destroy every enemy that have made life to be difficult for your life. The thunder of God to strike with lightning and fire and turn them to nothing. This is the time to call on God. Call upon the thunder of God.
God, what there is the Kaddish?
Pray. Turn this prayer into struggling and wrestling.
God, what there is the Kaddish?
Pray this prayer as if you are wrestling with every power and energy in you. Open your mouth loud. Call the thunder of God to shatter and destroy and turn to nothing everything that have made life difficult for your life.
Lord God, yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Open your eyes. As you are praying this prayer with all your zeal and power, let your aim commensurate with the way you are praying that prayer. What the Holy Spirit instruct me to inform you is this. After the prayer you have rendered in the name of Jesus, hear the voice of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit says, amen. You are delivered from the hand of the enemy that have been struggling and be disturbing your life for a long time. In the name of Jesus. Glory be to God in the highest. Look straight to the servant of God and focus your eyes on him. Do you know the time of your miracle when it happened? Did you know the time, the actual time, the miracle of your life happened? The particular time Mama Bolare was rendering the gospel music. God told me, you have been delivered from the bondage that the world has put you in. Now listen to this. The words of this moment is no joke at all. Because the devil has not taken your matter with levity. The enemy that followed you from your home here, listen to me and hear what I've heard again. And God says, those enemies that have claimed your blessing so much that you are struggling and struggling just to make ends meet. I'm just talking to one single person in this crowd. Whosoever believes that the voice of God coming out is particularly for, you will not waste time in saying a loud amen when I pray for you. Listen to me before you say that amen. Those enemies that have claimed your blessing, and he said you will continue to carry this problem from 1 month to the other, that you will carry those problems from 1 year to the next year. This is what I see concerning you. When you have been delivered and set free tonight, those enemies that have put you in bondage and made things hard for your life, God has brought them all into prison of bondage in the name of Jesus. You that is saying a loud amen, as you are saying that amen, so is it. All your enemies are running into their prisons and bondage.
Ogo ni fun Olorun loke orun.
Glory be to God in the highest.